Opening unit of the course in tribal sociology, we tried to understand the meaning of the word tribe and the characteristics of tribal communities in general and the distinction between tribe and caste. From this unit onwards, we shall go a little deeper into the understanding of the varieties of tribes that are existing in our country. To open the episode, first we will talk about their distribution. Here in this lesson, I am not going into the details in terms of percentage and other numbers with respect to tribes. We give a general idea about how some of the well-known tribes are distributed in our country. Starting with Arunachal Pradesh, Apatani is one of the noted tribes from Arunachal Pradesh. Assam, Kuki tribe. Kuki tribe we must have heard of in recent times and seen in the news also that they are up to certain demands for their rights. Bihar is known for the Kaniya tribe besides the Oravans. Himachal Pradesh, Gaddis are a very well known tribe. Madhya Pradesh, the Gonds are a noted tribe. Manipur, Kom. I am sure by reading the name Kom, you will remember Mary Kom, a tribal girl who went to the Olympics and came back with a bronze medal. Meghalaya, Khasi is one of the noted tribes. For your information, Khasi is a matrilineal tribe where the woman is more dominant than the man. Mizoram, obviously the Mizo tribe. Again, Mizo tribe quite like the Kukis. In fact, they belong to the same original group of tribes. They are also up to some rebellion demanding their rights. Nagaland, Angami Naga. Normally by the word Naga, we understand all Nagas are the same. There are nearly 10 to 12 different Nagas, and one of the Nagas to which belongs our former speaker of the assembly. Rajasthan is known for the Bhil tribe. We will read more about Bhil little later in this episode. West Bengal is known for Santals. Santals are also known for a very large scale movement they brought about demanding their rights over the land. Next, we will go into the composition and location of tribes. Again, like I said earlier, I will not go into any numbers and percentages, give a general information about how these tribes are spread over the country. Bhils are known in Rajasthan, although there are Bhils in certain other parts of India like the central belt. But Bhils are by and by identified with Rajasthan. Now, Bhils also claim some identity with Ramayana. In fact, they claim that Valmiki, the person who was behind the composition and writing of Ramayana, was a Bhil. Gonds, particularly Marya Gonds from the Bastar district of Madhya Pradesh, known for their bison horn dance, which is world famous in the tribal world. Santals from West Bengal, as I said earlier, known for their rebellion attitude on a large scale demanding their land rights. Nagaland, Nagas, as I said earlier, there are 10 to 12 different Nagas, although we have a general name Nagaland as if it was only one tribe. Kugis and Bodos of Assam are together in one group demanding their rights. And particularly reclamation of their land rights. There is a big Bodo movement that you might have heard of through the TVs and the newspapers. Khasi and Garo in the northeast, both of them in the Khasi and Garo hills and Jaintia hills spread over in northeastern part are a matrilineal tribe. We will speak more about it little later. Mizos of Mizoram. Mizos along with the Kukis and Bodos have also been involved in demanding their rights in their lands. Chenchus of Andhra Pradesh. Chenchus, actually it is very difficult these days to distinguish them from the larger castes. They have almost assimilated along with the caste groups directly involved also in agriculture. Gaddis of Himachal Pradesh. Gaddis are a very hard working people. They are very robust in their health, particularly as they live on the hilly tracts, moving up and down miles and miles every day for their livelihood. Paliyans and Todas of Tamil Nadu. Paliyans have a very interesting history. Once they were landlords, they are interested in gambling, losing all their lands. They are now working as laborers in the lands in which they were owners themselves. Lands have been taken over by the neighboring civilized people. Civilized, I said. You can ponder over the word civilized, if they could hoodwink the Paliyans to own their lands. Todas, the other famous name among the tribals from Tamil Nadu. In fact, Todas physiologically, racially have remained a question mark. With their tall stature, fine long nose and their complexion, they are very much unlike the rest of the tribals in South India. Kadars of Kerala, particularly in the Cochin area, they are known as one of the remaining food gathering tribes in the world. Lambanis of Rajasthan, although they are originally identified with Rajasthan, they are in the western belt down up to southern parts of Maharashtra and even northern parts of Karnataka. Kurubas and Soligas are among the leading tribes in Karnataka. Mundas of Jharkhand are a very well-known, in fact, one of the most famous tribes from India, particularly after Birsa Munda participated as a leader in the freedom movement. Oravans of Orissa are known as one of the most progressive among the tribes in our country. Some highlights we will have presently about some of the chosen tribes from India. Bodos. Bodos are a very, very well-known tribe from the Northeast. Bodos actually did not have any religion by and by. They were ancestor worship people. They were worshipping only their forefathers. They owed all that they had only to their forefathers until they came under strong influence of Hindu. Today, Hindu religion rules the Bodo religion. That means Bodos follow many Hindu gods and goddesses today. Hamar are another tribe down from Himalayas, as the name probably indicates. In fact, their ancestry is identified down from the northern parts of the Himalayas. Khasis, as I indicated earlier, is a matrilineal society. In fact, woman is the one who is the breadwinner for the family. Husband is to play a subservient role. Except for the first few months that the child is to depend for mother's milk, the mother takes care of the child. Afterwards, the growing child is put in the lap of the man who has to take care of the house. Wife goes for earning. In fact, wife is dominant. Husband is supposed to be subservient. This is almost a rule in all matrilineal families. In fact, the story goes that if a husband is ever seen admonishing the wife and trying to dominate the wife, he will be punished through a tribal panchayat diktat. Gaddis from the Himalayas, very hardworking people. And in fact, an average adult Gaddi is able to carry a weight 2 to 3 times his own body weight. Bheel is a very famous name among the archers, particularly when it comes to archery. Bheel is almost the first name. They are great archers. In fact, a story goes that when a son of an MLA had kidnapped one of the Bheel girls, they chased him. And in fact, they chased him right up to the palace. They want to exterminate. Police intervened. And the report goes that when their bows and arrows of various types were to be brought, there were truckloads of bows and arrows they had carried. Because among the Bheels, women are respected very highly. The other side of the Bheel is the women, the way they dress. In fact, an anthropologist has said that if a woman from the Bheel tribe dresses herself with all the decorative beads, she may not need her underclothing at all. Mundas, as I indicated earlier, from the Jharkhand region, they are a very, very well-known tribe. Mundas are very, very robust and very active and very alert. In fact, Munda is one of the tribes that openly participated in the freedom movement, as I referred to earlier. In fact, every year, in the name of Birsa Munda, who led the freedom movement on behalf of the Munda tribe is observed as a very special day. Dimasa of Assam, De Ma, actually De means water, Ma means the fourth. Now, Dimasa also identify their ancestry down from the northern parts of Himalayas. Gonds are a very widely spread tribe in Central Bend. In fact, up to about 18th century, there was an identity of Gondwana land which engulfed the entire middle part of India and also northern parts of Africa, parts of America and even Australia, right down up to Antarctica. But now Gonds are rather confined to the Central Belt. In fact, earlier the whole area was known as Gondwana land. Aravans are a leading tribe from Orissa, partly also Bihar. There is something unique about Aravans. Aravans love dance and music. In fact, this author was a witness to an Aravan dance. It's a very interesting sight. All the elderly people sitting all around, beating drums, of course, with their famous beer, the rice beer that they are famous for. They will be sitting, youngsters will be dancing in the middle of the circle, and if a particular young fellow is taking wrong steps, you could see an elderly man coming with the stick with which he is beating the drum, beating it on the leg of the young fellow and say that you are not stepping all right. They are great lovers of their dance and music. Chanchus of Andhra Pradesh, as I had observed earlier, are also now part of the larger Hindu community itself. It's very difficult to distinguish a Chanchu tribe from the regular caste people in Andhra Pradesh, particularly because Chanchus have also picked up the language of Telugu, probably sidelining their own dialect. In the next subunit of this unit, we will go little bit deeper into identifying the zones of these tribes in the spread of the country.